Brian Dowling, Kilkenny Camogie manager, congratulations for beating Cork, booking yourselves into another final as well. That Cork game, going into it, Brian, you know, there was mental hangover there as well for the girls and yourselves, based on a couple of those All-Ireland finals. You just got through it, and it was a tough match.
Yeah, it was a tough game. I suppose the start didn't go the way we wanted to, you know, but in fairness to the girls, they knuckled down after the first 10 minutes, you know. I think we got back into the game just before the first quarter. We were getting back on top. We just probably weren't getting the scores that we deserved, you know, missed a couple of easy chances. But, you know, we just said it after the first 15 minutes, to, you know, at the water break, to drive it on, just a bit more composure, a bit more clinical in front of goal. And, you know, we're right back in this game, not to panic. And in fairness, they didn't. That was a message kind of sending all year. Don't be panicking. There's going to be times where a team gets a run on you. Obviously, you prefer it didn't happen, but it is going to happen at times. So, look, we're happy with the composure the girls showed afterwards and the heart and the desire. You know, we kind of found a way to win without playing to the best of our ability. We found a way to get over the line, and that's probably something maybe that the team has been missing in the past. So look, we're delighted to win, and we're back in our Ireland final now, and we're really looking forward to it.
Yeah, so there would have been a bit of work on that consciously as well with them. Like you said, the water breaks have been handy, I suppose, in a sense that it gives you a bit of time to regroup, and if you need to get that message across to the girls, like, come on, I know we're down, but, you know, we're able to do this, let's push on.
Yeah, personally I find them great, you know, because it's hard to get messages across to the players during the game, but suppose there's sometimes you get a run on a team and the last thing you want is a water break, it stops the momentum, you know, and it's kind of hard maybe for some teams to get back into. So look, it works sometimes, it doesn't work other times, but it, you know, it is good if a team is setting up a certain way and you want to get a point across, you know, what way you want to counteract that. It's very good to get messages across. You only have a minute, I suppose, and you're trying to talk to the other management team first of all to try and work out what you're going to do, and then by the time you've that done, the players are supposed to go back out into the pitch. I know, I suppose the water break is supposed to be for the water, but I don't think it's been used for that at the moment, and it'd be interesting to see what the GAA do going forward now.
Absolutely. Galway have stepped up the last couple of years, obviously beaten by them last year in the final, and they came through this year fairly strongly as well. Another tough match going into a final, but good to have a fight against Cork, you know, to get you up for that final as well. You know, to have a tough match beforehand.
Yeah, look, Galway are an excellent team. You know, we know all about them from last year. We played them three times last year. You know, we only won once in the championship. They bet us in the league final and the All-Ireland final, obviously. And, you know, they were really good on the day. And they hit us early with a goal and then a couple of goals for half-time. You know, but look, that game against Cork was very tough, very physical. And, you know, I think you do get a lot from winning a game like that. I think it's better than any 3 or 4 weeks training, you know, a good championship win. And look, we don't know, but hopefully that game will stand to us now on Saturday night.
Brian, you came in, you're obviously the manager now, taking over for Man, but you were part of the backroom team and the management the last few years, but this year you get to sort of, you know, you're the manager yourself and that, but having that experience, I suppose, the last few years working with them as well, would have made it a bit easier this year, considering the year it's been, I suppose.
Yeah, look, definitely. I suppose it takes a bit of time to get to know players, to set up the team the way he wanted to set them up, you know. In fairness to Anne last year, she would have given me a big say in kind of how I wanted to set up the team and that, like, you know, she wasn't holding back in that regard. Look, you know, I got to know a lot of the girls obviously last year. We brought in a lot of new girls this year, so, you know, it was good to have that experience. And I think even to know the opposition, you know, I wouldn't really have been familiar with the opposition maybe last year as it would have been this year. You know, I know all the players now inside out, and I think that's probably one of the big things that stood to me this year over last year.
Your forwards have been on fire this year. The scores have been fairly good and fairly high compared to other teams and higher than Galway's, I suppose, and equally on the other side, you know, less goals and points conceded than Galway as well. They're only small little stats, I suppose, at the end of the day, but they're small little pieces of encouragement as well as to how your team is doing.
Yeah, I suppose you can look at all these things. I suppose a lot of it maybe depends on the opposition that you're playing as well. But look, we think we have a good team. We know Galway have a good team. I know we were the highest scoring team in the championship last year going into the final, and it didn't matter. So look, we're just focusing on this All-Ireland final now. And, you know, I suppose what we've done before is not going to matter. It's going to matter for the 60 minutes that we're in Croke Park next Saturday night.